This is Coogan Cassius for Rifle London. We're at the TKO gym here in Canning Town. With me, I've got super middleweight prospect Frank Buglioni. What's happening, Frank?
Nah, nothing much. Coogan just finished a nice session here with Mark and getting ready for the 21st.
21st is quickly approaching. Obviously, you knew he was going to be on this bill for quite a long time now. So, preparation, training-wise, everything ready for come next Saturday?
Yeah, definitely. It's been a quicker turnaround this time from the last fight, which has done me a favour, really. I feel good. I've had some good quality sparring, all varied, and looking to implement some improvements.
Your last fight out against Psonko, chance to watch it back. How have you assessed it?
Yeah, it's no secret that was wasn't a great performance from myself. Got frustrated at times and definitely took too many shots. But they're the things we've worked on, and there'll be a difference in this performance.
The other night, Callum Smith fought that same opponent, as you know, and stopped him within a round.
Showed us how to do it.
Well, you know, Callum Smith, right, you're you. But how would you assess him as he's building up? Obviously, he's had less fights than you, but climbing up that super middleweight ladder.
Oh, he's a good fighter. He's had the same pedigree as me in the GB team, and he's making a very good pro as he continues. And it's only a matter of time before our paths cross. And I'm confident of what I can do, and I'm sure he's confident of what he can do.
So obviously, your last couple of performances, would you say that they wasn't the real Frank Buglioni compared to, you know, your first few fights you had?
I'd say the last one, but the one before that against Darren McKenna, I didn't think it was a bad performance. Found the shots, found the body shots, found a chin shot as he walked onto it as well. So that'll be. But I've had good quality sparring against the likes of Nathan Cleverley, Andy Lee, just to name a few, really. So no, I'll be stepping up now.
Was you bickering with Chris Eubank as well?
Yeah, that it came from an interview that I did, and I was asked if I'd fight Chris Eubank Jr. I said I'd fight him tomorrow. I'm not worried about Chris Eubank Jr. And I don't think he's the real deal, to be honest with you. So that's a fight. If it happens, it happens. But I don't think he wants these sort of fights.
I think everyone in this gym wants to fight Chris Eubank Jr. by the sounds of it.
Well, he's obviously getting up. He's getting under people's skin. So he's doing something right. But that'll be something we'll find out probably in not the near future, probably the distant future, what Chris Eubank's all about.
21st of September, are you fighting for a title? Are you fighting for a Southern Area title?
No, I've got a 10-rounder this time, and then hopefully a Southern Area shot before Christmas.
So, I mean, you was hoping to have it for that date, wasn't you? We spoke to you before a few months ago that when you knew that you had this date, but the shot will come, won't it?
Yeah, of course. If I just continued along the line, this will be the most important fight that I'll be thinking of, this next one. And then I'll sit down with Frank and go from there.
How many of the Buglioni army are expected at the Copper Box?
I think we've got about 600.
600?
Yeah, about 600, yeah. It's going to be noisy. It's going to be noisy, Coogan.
It's going to sound it. So, boxing aside, what else have you been up to? Obviously, there's been a sort of traditional mid-season break in August, but you've been, I can imagine, being still in the gym, obviously.
Yeah, I feel like I've been in the gym for a long time now. I had a nice week out after my last fight. And regrouped and come back from that. And I've been in the gym since and been getting some great sparring and some great training.
I see some pictures of you on a catwalk the other day. Was that right?
That was a while ago, Coogan. That was my fashion last year. This year's been strictly boxing.
Oh, right. I thought it was a new picture. Was it Vogue, wasn't it? Was it?
I don't know. I don't know what's been pushed out there.
Yeah, no, I've done a bit myself in the past, but. Why are you laughing?
Well, no, you've done a little bit. You've done a bit of weight as well.
They do an Asian Vogue, and I've been the cover for it. That cover.
Not wearing that, I hope.
Gleeson's gym.
Yeah, we're getting a Team Buglioni one.
You've been threatening to do that for the last 2 years since you turned pro.
Well, you told me you're neutral and you can't do it, so I ain't wasted a good quality fleece on you.
You're doing fleeces now as well?
Oh, yeah. Proper. Weather's changed now. Summer's over, so T-shirts are out, fleeces are in.
Yeah. Fight a foreigner. Wear it.
All right, yeah. Fair play. I'll bring you one up.
Okay. All right, well, listen, thanks for waiting. Did you wait long, by the way?
Yeah, I waited quite long for you, Coogan. I was ready to slip out the door, but I thought I'd show you a little bit of respect.
You heard my name mentioned, you thought you'd
hang around for
how long would you have waited for before you thought, fuck that, I'm going?
Oh, it was only Ben that threatened me if I left, then he'd chin me, so I waited. But otherwise, I would have been gone.
He told you if you left, your contract expires.
Well, that's it. That's why I had to wait, didn't I?
Obviously. All right, Frank, thank you very much for talking to us. Good talking to you again, and look forward to seeing who you're facing on the 21st of September.
Yeah, lovely. Thanks very much, Coogan.
Coogan Cassius with Frank Buglioni for iFilm London. Thank you very much.